Generic greetings and welcome to Beverage Plus Blood Bowl KFC Edition once again. Today's beverage is a nice cup of tea. And yes, the slurping is back due to popular demand. I said I wasn't going to do that anymore, but people said it was such an integral part of the beverage videos that we can't get rid of it. And yeah, I guess it is. Obviously, I don't do that in polite society, but I guess for these sort of things, it's okay. Anyway, this is the Dark Bite team, yeah, our vampire team that we did in the series. Now, the thing is, I always wanted to do the Blood Bowl series, and I did a full video on the choices of videos and then decided that yeah, I should just end up playing the games that I want regardless of the pressure and such. And obviously with some caveats on that, but still, yes, I wanted to do a Blood Bowl series, I did it, and not many people watched it, but I didn't really care because the people that did watch it really liked it. And the thing is, I finished the series on a high note because we did actually get a win, but people always wondered what happened to the Dark Bite, so I thought we would jump in and just play another game, just a quick match. So as you can see, team value 1,700 there, we have our four vampires. If we just go to the, where is it, team roster, there we go. We've got Count Rex Youngblood is a very, very good vampire level. Three. All my vampires are level 3 there, as you can see. They've all got block and dodge as standard. There you go, all the way down the list, so they are a blodger. Obviously, they're still vampires, so strength 4, agility 4. Very good indeed. Our overall star, I guess, would be Von Karstein. There is 25 star player points. Not bad at all. We've also got a couple of good thralls as well. We've got Vassal Kroll, which has got 10 star player points, level 2. We've also got Ivan, who did a really, really good drive and got pretty much the 11 star player points in one go, and also we got Pavel as well, so they've all got decent stats. Pavel has actually got Kick, which is a bit of a weird one. We've got Dankivek, which has got Wrestlers also. We've got three Wrestle guys. 110,000 generic units of gold coloured currency in the treasury, which is obviously really, really good for buying things, but we want to buy a reroll, but it's 140,000, so we can't do that. Anyway, let's just go and prepare a match, and we're going to have a quick bash around here, and looks like we are versing the Frozen Phantoms. And they are the undead. Okay, and they have the same team value as me. They have 1,700. This is actually a brand new season because we did win the previous season. So, yeah, not bad at all. Vampires being quite hard to coach, but really, really fun. The thing is, I know a lot of people watch these Blood Bowl videos, and especially when it's just on. More people watch the series than they did the actual quick beverages, but still, I just like playing the game. It's just a game that I keep coming back to, and I'm really, really looking forward to Blood Bowl 2. I've seen the footage for that, and it looks really good. However, looks can be deceiving. It's all about the gameplay for it, because this, I really hope that whatever they put in Blood Bowl 2 is more. I mean, if it's just going to be this game now, as we're playing now, but with better graphics, I don't really see the point, because that, as far as I'm aware, Blood Bowl 2 has only got 8 teams are starting. This has got like 23 or something like that, so it's probably best to stick with this, and hopefully it doesn't divide the community, because this is still a quite dedicated community. Anyway, I'm kicking off here, so I need to set up, because if you receive, you get a very, very good. If you're the one on the receiving end, then you don't get a bonus per se, but you do get to do your violence-y bit first. Anyway, there's a guy with Kick. I don't want him on the front line, certainly not. I'm looking for the other Thrall to wrestle. There we go. We just put some of the Thralls around here. We're going for a staggered formation where we are, well, as you can see, staggered. So there's all of these tackle zones all the way around here, so they can't just run past. We've got Von Karstein, everybody else in the center. They're all pretty much the same. That's got Wrestle, Kick, and I think that will do it. Or do we put the vampires like that? I think it'd be best to put the vampires in the back like so. Yeah, that'll probably be better just in case something tries to run. So anyway, let's see if we can verse the undead. Now, undead are really, really tough. They have mummies, which are the hardest guys in the game, really. We've got a kickoff table of throw rock, and Rage Halsfern throws rock at pretty much one of each, and it's given me a niggling injury, which is plus 1 to any subsequent injury roll made against the player for who was that? Just one of our guys there, one of our thralls. So my thrall's been taken out, so already we're down one player. That's not good. Welcome to Blood Bowl. This is how it goes all the time, pretty much. Anyway, the undead team They are, oh, interesting. Looks like they just punched my guy down in the face there. You can see their mummies. Movement 3, garbage. Strength 5, excellent. Agility 1, garbage. And arm value of, oh, this is my guy getting knocked out. And now I'm down to 9 players. And that might be 8 players. No, no, there we go. We're down to 9 players on the pitch so far, and I haven't even had my first turn. Good grief indeed. So, yes, mummies. Keep out where mummies, because they are not good. And pretty much beat up the ghouls. Ghouls are just standard sort of human-y stuff, but they all have dodge. If I remember rightly, yes, they do. They do have zombies as well, which are pretty garbage. We can punch them to the deck. And they've actually left their ghoul right at the back, which is an interesting one. So let us begin. Let's get Wildsaw the Handsome up and moving. And we're going to put him about there, just so we get a 2-dice block around the area there. What we're going to do is try and do a bit of a fight here. We're going to run our vampire up. This is Von Karstein. We're just going to get him running up and then do a bit of pressurizing on the ball there. I've got 4 rerolls. They've got 3. Let's just do a 2-dice block here, and it's worked out. They have Dauntless and Block. Dauntless is when you're attacking someone with it's stronger, you get a little bonus, or you can get them. So Defender Stumbles will do this quite nicely. Let's push him there and follow it up, and there we go. That's not bad. Now what I'm going to do is get some of my vampires in and around this brawl here. So we'll move a vampire there. Obviously, they've all got Bloodlust, which is something that you have to be wary of. Let's push him probably out of the way and then not follow it up, because what we want to do is create this strong line. Now, that's still a 1-dice block. I'll go for it. It's a bit risky. It's a pushback, which has worked out. We'll not follow that up. And then what I will do is do a blitz into that guy there, which is one of the... what is it? Just a skeleton, and looks like I've got both down, but I've got block and he's got block, so we're just going to sort of bang, punch each other there. Then I'm just going to dodge out of his tackle zone and stand around, I think about there will do us quite nicely, just so they can't run past. Then we'll end the turn there. Let's not be overly aggressive. It's always a downside of Blood Bowl. If you start going overly aggressive, then you can, especially if you can't keep up with your own team, then it's not the best decision, really. Looks like, however, they are caging right up, and that's something that I will have a problem with, because mummies, yeah, mummies, strength 5. Even my vampires, which are arguably one of the hardest units in the game, obviously Bloodlust sort of negates that a little bit, but mummies are just, they're just bricks. I mean, look at that. Armor value 9, strength 5, mighty blows, standard regeneration, so they get back up. And this one's got stand firm, grab and multiple block. The one on the floor, guard and piling on, so not great, is it? Anyway, let's do a bit of cheeky pushing about here. That's not worked out for me. Looks like that's attacker down and both down. I'm going to have to re-roll that, which I didn't want to do. And then got both down, which means I'm going on the floor. So that didn't work out whatsoever. That's bad. That's gone quite bad, because what he could do here is move that ball there, fling it to that other ghoul, and then get that ghoul running in. He could make it. Looks like he's not going to do that. He's actually caging back up, obviously using the mummy as the cage. Now, I can break it, but what I'll have to do is probably use Hypnotism, which is an ability that the... It's pretty much solely vampires, I believe. I think there's one star player, which I think himself is a vampire anyway. Hypnotic Gaze, you hypnotize the opponent so they don't have a tackle zone and such. So it might work out, it might not. But either way, not good so far, because I've got many people. Look at that cage they're trying to make there. It's actually a very, very successful cage. But one of the things is they are quite slow, their team. Their team is quite slow. Looks like they're pushing my vampire around there, which isn't too bad. Then what I'll do is try and get inside there. Right, okay, so let's... First things first, we need to get these ghouls up and moving, okay? So get the ghouls up and move them into a position where they are going to be near my vampires, okay? Or at least move them into a position where we know we can get some assists in. There we go. That one can't stand up. I'll use this vampire to not... it's still only going to be a 1-dicer. See, what I need to do is get that guy's ball off him, but it's 2 dice they're choosing. I'm going to have to go through 2 tackle zones. Not going to work out. Even against that guy, look at that. Against the mummy, 2 dice. So what I'm going to do is move him in. No bloodlust there. And then we will do a hypnotic gaze on him, and it's worked out. So there you go. He's now hypnotized, which means he doesn't have a tackle zone. So I can start crack... I'll just start cracking the cage a little bit here. And that's only a pushback, but I can push the ball carrier towards that side, and we will follow it up. There we go. So now the ball carrier is in that corner. And then what I'll do is I'll crowd him with another vampire. There we are. And then I'm going to do a cheeky one dicer, which might not work out. It has worked out. Defender stumbles. Oh, he's got dodge, so it's not going to work out. But it means I can push him there and then follow it up. Not bad. And there we go. So it's turn 4 for them. Yeah, so they're halfway through the first drive. Obviously, it's an 8-8 game. However, I am still 2 players down to start off with. You know, having 2 players down right at the beginning is not great. These are really a bashy team. They are really a bashy team. I mean, they can actually do a little bit of running, but not really. I mean, they use the mummies for effect. It looks like he's got a frenzy and a pushback there. They use the mummies for full effect and start beating the crap out of you. In fact, I think you can make a team with 4 mummies. I did try to do that once, and I just don't like it. They're so situational. Like, now, that's their perfect situation there. Basically caged up, kicking the crap out of everything. As you can see, look, they've just knocked 2 vampires down to the deck, so that's what they do. However, they are they're built for that and pretty much nothing else. So if you can get around them, then it's not too bad. Now, if they've... What's happening here? They're dauntlessing that vampire out the way. They might have left that ball a bit open. They have left that ball open, right? Okay, let's start moving people around then. Let's move my thrall up to there. That's Boris. And then I want to get a vampire in there to blitz him. Now, that'll be 1 dodge out of there. Or do I want to use anything else? That's still a get up and a dodge. Might as well do that one. So here we go. So I have to get up, which is fine. No bloodlust. Dodged out the way, no problem. And then a blitz, which is perfect result. I'm versing the ghoul. God, look at that ghoul. Strength 3, as you might expect, standard. But dodge, block, prone, sure hands. So the only way for me to bring him down is to use a defender down, which I've got. And I will push him straight towards the wall. And hopefully the ball will go straight off, which it hasn't. It's actually on my feet. I failed to pick up, but I am going to re-roll that to pick it up. And I now have the ball. That is something I did not expect. Right, let's just... I've just bloodlusted. That's not good. Right, so I've bloodlusted there. What I wanted to do is get around the back here and actually... Ah, dear. Bloodlust, can't reroll because I've used my reroll. So, at the end of this guy's turn, I will be either walking off the pitch to bite some unlucky crowd member, or I will have to be biting a thrall. There's a thrall there. There's one back there. I want to be around this position, so I'm going to have to dodge over there. Dodged out the way, no problem. And then we'll go to about here, and then we will end the end action. Bite that thrall there, which has put him face down. It's not too bad. We'll stand the other vampire up, but do we want to dodge him out of the way? No, we'll just keep him where he is. Let's do a bit of a 2 dice. Damn it! Right, this guy has now bloodlusted. There's no point in trying to dodge out the way. I'm just going to push him back over to there. And then that guy is going to be sent off. There we go. That's a shame. That is a shame. I could have, you know, not done that, I guess. I could have, like, tried and dodge out the way and get around. But honestly, I'm so low on the thralls now, I really don't want to start knocking them down. This is where it's going to start going horribly wrong. I mean, you could argue that it's already gone quite horribly wrong. There's a pile on by their mummy, which is not great because it has to stand up, so it's pretty much out for a turn. Looks like, oh yeah, that vampire is going to get his ticket punched. And he's got dodge, so he's just got pushback. That's got frenzy, I believe, which has still just pushed him back. That's all he's managed to do. That's pretty good. That is pretty good. And they're still knocking these down. They're knocking all these guys down. And I've got 3 thralls back here that I need to get back in the mix. They've just knocked another vampire down. But that'll be almost the end of their turn here. It is. Right, okay. Right, now we have to start thinking about this. Let's just get the thrall up, because he's not going to be doing anything other than making that mummy fight him. I really need to get that guy out of the way. That's several dodges. That's not going to work that way. I could run that way. That's still 2 dodges. What if I push that vampire out? See, these whites got good agility and mighty blow. Oh, God, I'm block a standard. Right. Let's move that thrall into here. And then stand this vampire up. We need to keep the vampires standing up. Like so. There we go. That hasn't bloodlusted, which is good. Then what I want to do is get... If I get that that thrall... Do I want to put him there? I think that was a mistake, actually, putting him there. because when that guy stands up, he's going to be in two tackle zones. Yeah, mistake putting him there. Oh, well, right. That's two dodges to get out of the way. What I'll try and do is I'll try and hypnotise that guy. It's not really going to help, is it? I could dodge him that way. If I dodge him out that way and run down to there, that's still a lot of dodges. Let's just try and dodge out first. That's worked out. So if I just do that, just run that way. Just run it out. Just run the ball out. Two go for it just to get an extra bit of edge on them. That's worked out. Then this vampire, we could dodge out and get over there. One dodge. Two dodges. And he's crowded. Okay, that's worked out. Now, the mummies are too slow to really get to me. And the thing is, with that guy being there, that's worked out as well. Because it means that when that mummy stood up, he couldn't then just walk out of the tackle zone. Because look, he would have been able to get there otherwise. So yeah, that's what I was on about earlier, about the mummies being very situational. They're too slow to be really... They certainly can't chase anything. They'll never chase anything down, ever. But, yeah. They'll never, ever, ever chase anything down. But they don't have to, as you can see when they're mighty blowing things to the ground. Now, what I'm running out of is Thrall. So I'm just going to run my vampire up and hopefully I've bloodlusted. I will re-roll it, and I've passed that, so that's okay. Now, I don't particularly want to... I'll just stand these other guys up, you know. I don't particularly want to move another vampire over there, but I'm going to have to just to get a bit of cage up. There we go. Now, this vampire, he's only on one dice for pretty much everything. Let's stand the other thralls up. Just keep standing the thralls up. I don't know how safe that guy is. He might be quite safe. And it also might be worth not throwing a block here, but when have I done something that I've done a lot of things I shouldn't. Let's have a defender stumbles. That's okay. Go there and we'll not push him. We'll not follow up because we're going to do another cheeky one dicer. And it's worked out again. Defender stumbles. Oh no, he's got dodge and block, so it's just going to push him back. But we will follow it up though. Just again, to crowd all of these guys here. So by the look of it, I've got two more turns to get that in the back. I've only got one reroll, though. But there isn't really anything that can chase him down, apart from these ghouls, which is exactly what he's doing now. He's moving the ghouls around. Well, by the look of it, he's actually taking out the thralls. Yeah, he is taking the thralls out. It's a very good tactic, actually. Let's just stand the thrall up. Again, stand the thralls up. Keep them on the deck so they have to keep punching away. Now, I've got lots of ablative thralls, so I don't really care what happens to them. Let's just move this up here again. We don't want a bloodlust, which we haven't. Now, I could try and run it in and make it safe. Let's try it. There's a go for it. And I'm going to have to re-roll the go for it roll. And it worked out only just, though. Only just. So we had a 2+ go for it and we failed, but we did re-roll it. There's a touchdown. And we managed to pull that one off. So it is 1-0 to me just before half time. We will get... There's one my guy that's injured. There's one that's knocked out. I'm not going to get them back. I don't really care that much because we've got some spare thralls. Organise my players before kicking off. It seems about right. Yeah, that's about right there. Obviously, I'm kicking off, so they get to receive, which means they get one free turn of basically punching the shite out of me. Blitz, the defense starts to drive fraction early, so they get a free bonus turn. Okay, I get a bonus turn, do I? Well, in that case, I'm going to charge forward with Vampire, punch this guy in the face, like that, and then we will not follow it up, and then we're going to pull back to about there. And we'll do the same thing up this side. We'll just run... I've just bloodlusted with that Vampire. That's not good. We'll run him up to there. Then we will end the action. Eat that thrall next to me there, which has faced him down. Right, I could run up to there to pick that up, but you know what? I think I'm just going to reposition like that, and then we'll call that there. I've knocked someone back. That will do, won't it? That will do indeed. So they've just tried to pick the ball up. Look at Joey, we've got two hands. Obviously, this is their last turn. They can't do anything. They certainly can't score this half, which means I've got a 1-0 at half time. Not bad. Certainly a lot better than I thought. It's a lot better than I thought we were going to do right at the beginning when we got two guys knocked straight down. Right. Looks like it's my turn now. Now, do I want to? I could. Ooh, I could start being a bit cheeky, and maybe punch their mummy down. Do I want to try it? Could do it, couldn't I? Yeah, let's try and punch their mummy down. I don't think it's going to do anything. But, defender down. Push him that way. Bang, there he goes down. And get a thrall stomping on him. Yeah, let's stomp on him. I don't really care if he gets sent off. Let's just go. Ah, there we go. It hasn't done anything and the ref didn't see me. Right, let's just... There's nothing really else really to do. Just move these up. This is the last one anyway. And... Cheeky one dicer. Could move another thrall up. Maybe get a two dicer on that. Cheeky two dice. Yeah, why not? Oh, it's worked out. And bang, we push him onto the deck there. And that's about it. We'll end the turn. And there's the first half. Not bad. Not a bad first half. I did manage to punch their mummies down. I like the way when the mummies actually go lie on the ground. There's all my cheerleaders there. I like the way when the mummies go on the ground, they lie completely flat as if they were still in a sarcophagi or something. Sarcophagus? Sarcophagi? Don't know which is the right one. Anyway, I am receiving the kickoff this time, so the person with kick does not need to be on the pitch. And I want anyone with wrestle on the front lines, as always. And I think that will do it, and we'll just accept that there. So I get first turn. I still like the staggered setup, and there goes the ball. Dark Bite me, gets an extra team reroll. Not bad at all. So let's start getting some thralls up here, and we'll do some two dices. So there's a nice one. Defender stumbles, push him back and not follow it up. Bang, there it goes. And then we need to get someone with the ball, so we'll get Wildsaw the Handsome to pick it up on a 2+. Not bad at all. And then we're going to run it over here, and then we're going to fling it to another vampire for a 2+. Quite easy. And there it goes. Yeah, nice little thing there. Whee! Lovely, lovely. And then we're going to get our other vampire straight up. I think we'll get... I'll just run him straight up this one, this side here. And I just want to crowd everything. Then we're going to get the ball carrier to blitz straight up. That's a bloodlust. I'm not going to reroll it. So I will just go to there instead and then hit him there. And it means I can bite that thrall next to me if I need to. And that is a defender stumbles. So he'll go there. I will not follow it up. And then we will actually end the action there. Bite that thrall next to me, which has put him there. That's not too bad. Alright, let's get some more thralls straight up. I want to get a very aggressive drive on this one. Get another vampire straight up again, crowding this ball. Something fierce. And then I want to get the third vampire that I haven't touched yet. Just up there. That's fine. So that's two dice he chooses. Two dice he chooses. Sometimes it's best not to do anything. So there you go. Turn 9 of 16. Looks like he's running a guy quite long on the other side with a ghoul. And then he's crowding the ball with the zombie there. And actually managed to hit one of my thralls with the ghoul. Face up, so it's not too bad. It'll stand up next turn, I believe. Oh, actually dodging around there. And here comes the blitz, probably against my vampire. It is. Not against the ball carry, though. And he's just pushing back, but frenzy will kick in. And we both have blocks, so that's fine. That's worked out. Looks like the... Mighty Blood. Yeah, I've got my... Yeah, one of my thralls has been mighty blowed, so not good. But it's going to happen when you've got ghouls with armor value 7, which is under average. 8 is about the average, I believe. And you've got mummies whacking them with 5 strength, basically 3 dice they choose for the most part. And yeah, it's not going to work out too well for you. Right, so I have to box clever on this one because I need to get this ball further up. But it's a bit heavy around that corner, so I could literally run it off to here, pass it to him, and then run it up the other side. I think that's what we're going to do, you know. We are going to simply play it safe. So we'll stand that guy up. Then we will two dice block that guy out the way, which has not worked out. I'm going to reroll it. There's a pushback. That's fine. Push him there and follow it up to there. My other vampire is going to run into there. Actually, I'll just do a handoff. It's easier if I just do a handoff. Go to there, hand it off. There we go. We could fling it. You get some star player points, but there's no point. Just hand it off and then run up the other side. So we'll get a cage up first. let's be a bit naughty. And then we'll... Oh, this is bad. I shouldn't have really gone for the two go for rolls. I can't look. Oh, it worked out only just though. Ooh, that was close. Right, okay. So, still got a blitz. So here's my blitz. I want to get this mummy out the way. Worked out. Push back. Oh, he's got stand firm, so it hasn't worked out. So I'm just going to have to try for a dodge. So I just want to go up there. And he's managed to get out the way. That's fine. So there's a little bit of a cage. We're going to get the other thrall out. No, we're not. I've already had a reroll. So there he goes on the deck. out of beverage now. Right. So, cage is up. Or at least it's up enough for me to not really worry about someone completely blitzing the centre guy. There's the one and only blitz of the turn. He's managed to push a Thrall back. Nothing funky. Constantin with Wrestle. And I can just simply dodge the vampire out of there. However, yeah. That is getting very, very crowded already. And that could mean he could chase me down. These things can chase you, the ghouls, and they're not very strong. Don't really need to be when they're in numbers. That's something you will find out when you verse the Skaven, which is, when you verse someone like the Skaven, you find out that although they are strength 2 and 3, it doesn't really matter when there's several of them. Right. Let us get this Thrall up and moving. Any Thrall that's on the ground, we will shift. And I think I will stand that Thrall up and put them in probably contact. Do I want to put them in contact? Well, I'll stand that Thrall up there. Move that Thrall into there. Now, I do want to punch that mummy, but I realise it's a bit of a false economy trying to knock a mummy down. Right. Simply one dodge in it. I'll just run out the way. There's no reason for me not just to run. You know what I mean? I could be clever and do this, that, and the other, but I'll just run. I'll just run it out. And I'll just put this Thrall around here. There you go. Just keep running things around, putting everybody in sort of contact with them, so they're going to have to try and punch out the way. We'll move the vampire up here. And I want to get him to dodge out, which is worked out. We'll put him there. Get this guy to dodge out. Go there, which is worked out again. And I haven't done a blitz this turn, but we could do a blitz if we do that. Bloodlust, I will not reroll it. So I will redo my blitz over there. There we go. So again, I'll bite that guy there. So here we go. Worked out. Defender down. Go there. Follow it up. Knocked him out as well, which is good. End the action. Bite that Thrall in the middle. Job done. And I've also knocked him out as well. Oh, it's Von Karstein. Of course it's a Von Karstein vampire. The most aggressive we have on this team. So yeah, of course he would knock two players out, one of them being mine. Still, looks like the blitz is coming in against my Thrall. And down goes Spine Basher. Spine Basher? No, that Spine Basher is the ghoul. I was going to say. Yeah, it's Constantin. Yeah, again. But as you can see, the mummies, now I'm running away from the mummies, they can't chase me. You know, they can't get to me, so that works out. That works out for me. And all they really need to do is crowd me now, but obviously vampires agility 4 with dodge. None of them have got tackle, so they're not negating it. So it is a 2 plus rerolled, or a 3, even if it's a 3 plus rerolled, doesn't really matter what it is. It's still quite good, isn't it? Right, let's do a blitz here, because I want to get that guy out of the way. Push back, it's worked out. I'll push him to there and not follow it up. Then I want to get my other Thrall right up to here. Like so. And then, as always, you plan, you know, plan for the worst, which means that I might not get this dodge, and I'll have to mess around with moving people about and such, so we'll just get everybody around. Because if I fail and fall over and the ball falls, I don't want them to just pick it up and run it in. Right, I'm not going to move vampires because of Bloodlust. I'm just going to try and dodge out the way. There's a Bloodlust failure. Do you want to reroll it? No, I don't. So I just want to dodge out of the way. There we go. And then we will bite the Thrall next to me, which is why I put an M in the first place. Touchdown, 2-0. That's why I put the Thrall there right at the start. Some people are probably thinking, well, why'd you do that? Well, the reason is that there, look, that, because I knew that there's a possibility of that happening. There's a 1 in 6 chance when you activate vampires that they will bloodlust, obviously. So it's something you don't want to... You don't want to risk. I could have re-rolled it, but what's the point? If I plan ahead, I can save myself a re-roll. Just realised some horrible popping on these guys here. Yeah, the crowd. It's a bit lo-fi in places now. I mean, the game is getting on a bit, but it's still a bloody... It's amazingly good game. Some people say they don't like it, they don't get it, but, you know. I guess these things are going to happen, right? Wrestle on the front. No, we don't want anyone with kick on the front, that's for sure. And now we are kicking. There we go. Right. Turn 12. Of 16, Blizzard. Amazing. That is just what I wanted. So, people will, if they go for it, so go an extra space, it is a roll of 1 or 2, meaning they'll fall on the deck. And also, it means that only short or quick passes can be attempted. Which means That is really the advantage to me. I'm now on the defensive, right? As soon as I put that second one in the box, perfect. I only needed, you know, I really just need to hold on now. And I don't think they could have equalised. I don't even think they could have equalised. They certainly couldn't have won from that point on. As soon as I put that in, on turn 12, 2-0, they can't win. They could have equalised, but it would have been hard for them. Now, nigh impossible because of this snow. It means they can't push it. They can't push it, go a little bit further. They can't do any long passes. If they put a guy right down the back, they can't fling it all the way. So it is really advantage to me. Excellent. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this opportunity to beat the living hell out of every single one of their players. So here we go. There's a two dice block. There's a pushback. So I'll push it to there, not follow it up. No point. Then I will... What do we do here? Let's just get some vampires in. There's a bloodlust. I'll re-roll it. Why not? Don't really need to worry about it too much. Get another vampire in. There's another bloodlust. Two bloodlusts in a row. So we'll put him there and then we'll eat the thrall next to him, which is going to be badly hurt. No long-term effect. But that's not great. It's still not a great effect, is it, when you badly hurt your own team? Right. Let's charge in here. And we'll get that zombie out of the way now. And I failed the go for it roll required. So that was just a bad round altogether. And I badly hurt one of my own guys. I used a reroll and a vampire's on the floor. Perfect. So, yeah, if I end up giving this touchdown away, then, you know, I sort of deserve to feel bad. You have played bad and you should feel bad. Yes, definitely. Right. It looks like they're crowding that ball up. All I'm going to do is just get around it. Looks like you tried to attack me there, and that thrall has wrestle. Is that right? Hang on. No, the thrall has wrestle, but he went down. We both didn't go down, so it looks like you've got a red skull, which is, you know, attacker down. Excellent. That's what we like to see. Right, let's just get around here. Now, there's a bit of a horrible tactic you can pull off, and that is, it's something you really use against the dwarves. Oh, look at that, badly hurt. Very nice. Who was that that did it? Pavel? Was that Pavel? It was Pavel. Excellent. Right. Yeah, a great tactic. Well, I say a great tactic. It's all right tactic. Let's just push that guy. I'm just going to start bullying them in this corner, to be honest with you. There we go. Oh, just keep pushing them about. There we go. Lovely, lovely. And that's still only one dice. I want to get a blitz in. Two dice, but it's a go for it roll. I don't think I'll try that. I'm just going to move them up like that. Yeah, what you can try, what you do is you just put them next to each other like that. You just put them next to each other with one space left, right? Because one space left means that they can only move forward and do one blitz. Speaking of blitzes, I'm going to do a cheeky one here and then run back. Batter into there. Not follow it up. And then run back into there. Oh, actually, I can't because of the... I can't actually. No, it's a bit too many go for it there. So what we'll do is we'll try and dodge out of there. Yeah, and we'll just crowd it. So all it can do is either go through me or try and go around, which since I'm fairly spread out now, to get that guy around, they're going to have to go all the way around there, through tackle zones, through there, through tackle zones. Or they could just bash a hole and try and run through. That guy has got dodge. Only agility 3 though, so oh, I got pro as well, so the pro could work out. Pro, there's a 50-50 chance of you getting a reroll. It always reminds me of that Anchorman quote, is it like 50% of the time it works every time? Yeah, so it's, yeah, it doesn't really work that way then. That's an interesting move, the one right at the back there. That's an even better move because I've got two more turns. I could, if I'm very, very lucky... If I'm very, very lucky, that isn't the luck that I needed, though. Do I want to go for it? Just see if I can do this. See if I can get this guy down. I might as well run a vampire up, because you can't really do anything else. So let's get that thrall up to there. Again, plan for the worst here. Push people around. Push it to there. Why not? Follow it up. Although I'm in a base contact with a mummy now, which is not great. Still trying to batter this guy down. He's not dodging everything, but I'm trying to push him away. Just move everybody in, why not? Right, let's try the risky thing. Go! So, it's two go for it rolls. So 50-50 chance of this not working, which it has actually worked out. I cannot believe that. I find that very, very hard to believe. And now, we've knocked that guy down. He's got thick skull. I'll just go for a one dicer, why not? It's a pushback. We'll follow it up, why not? Crowd the mummy. There we go. So, this is their second last turn. And they have that ghoul right at the back there with a vampire next to him. Which means that if he tries to dodge out and hopefully fails, the ball will land on the ground and I can pick it up and get it in and call it a 3-0. Probably what's going to happen though is he's going to dodge out. I don't think he's going to blitz me out there. The chances of him blitzing that vampire out are quite low, although it does require, yeah, require a couple of dodges on his part. Yeah, there we go. That's exactly what I wanted. Right. So he tried to dodge out the way, failed, and then the ball's landed on the deck. Right, okay. So I need to get that guy out of the way first, and that's going to be too many go for it. You know what? I'm just going to dodge out the way. 2+ pickup. I'm going to re-roll it because I have to, and then straight in the box, and we just made it a 3-0. I did not think that was going to work. Oh, that's why I love Blood Bowl for that. Some things, it goes horribly wrong most of the time, but sometimes you can just pull off things that are just amazing. 3-0, we've managed to do that on. Looks like we got some people back because some were knocked out. It doesn't really matter. We'll just go for a generic setup, apply it. It doesn't matter. They've just got one turn of bashing me. So unless they really do something a bit nasty, it's a blitz, so I actually get an extra turn. I'm not even going to take it. I'm just going to let the ball go over there. I don't want to go any further. I don't want to risk going forward and falling over. I don't really want to get any free bashes in, to be honest with you. Let's just call it there. And they can't win. I mean, 3-0. As I said earlier, the chances of them equalising are very slim. Soon as the blizzard came down, it was yeah, almost nothing. And now, yeah, it's a 3-0. It's a 3-0. I can't get another one in. I didn't think I'd make a 3-0. I thought 2-0. I was very happy with a 2-0. I thought, nah, 3-0? Nah. And the worst thing is, I haven't played this game in about 2 months. So, it is interesting that as soon as we jump straight in, I thought, oh no, I haven't actually versed the undead in quite a while. This is not going to go well. And then when two guys not went down straight away, I thought, oh, it's going to be another one of them losing videos. Oh dear, oh dear. Well, doesn't look like that's actually happened. cold tea. Ugh, horrible. Yeah, they're just doing a couple of free bashes, moving around, just as a, you know, just default option. And there we go. End of match. That is a win for the Dark Bite. Excellent. So, I rolled 4 for my winnings for a total of 60 gold pieces. Do you want to re-roll? No, I think that's fine. Let's not be too greedy. So, 60 gold. New fan factor. 8. Not bad. 40. Look at that. 43% ball possession. So, they've had the ball a lot more than me. And 77% occupation in opponent's half. So, although I haven't had the ball as much as them, when I have had the ball, it's in their half. Not bad. Team statistics, 2 tackles, 1 casualties. 1 casualty, it should be. One tackle. Sustained. 3 knockouts. Not bad. Not bad. Not overly aggressive, but that's fine. 3-0 is absolutely fine. Our team value has actually gone down a little bit. 1,670. If I just go to team roster, you'll see why. Because that guy has now got a damage back, which is a niggling injury. 120 subsequent injury rolls made against the player. That's fine. There's no real point in getting rid of them. Obviously, they are out for a match as well, okay? Are they out for a I think they're out for a match as well. But yeah, it's no real problem because Thralls are very, very ablative anyway. You don't really, you know, you buy them in bulks of 3, right? It's like it's either getting a buy one, get one 3, or you buy 2 and get the 3rd free. You know, you do buy them in bulk, certainly. You get them in crates, you know, 30 thralls, please, because you go through them like mad. Although this team hasn't had too many. We haven't gone through too many. What I'm going to do is get an extra reroll. There you go. So I am now at a team value of 1,740. There is the Dark Bite, and we are playing for high stakes. So, for maybe the one person that was wondering what happened to the Dark Bite, there you go. It's still playing, and it's still winning by the look of it. I like Blood Bowl. I really want to play Blood Bowl some more now. As always, comments in the comments. Thanks very much for watching. Take care, and generic partings.